Hello everyone, I'm Caleb with Danzy Design Build. Today I wanted to talk to you about something that's really important when you're doing walkout entry in Eagle Mountain. It's about the footing and foundation connection between the house and the addition that you're doing. So this would apply to walkout entries or additions that you're building onto your home. The way that this works is there's actually pieces of rebar inside the foundation wall that tie into the existing concrete foundation wall, and this also applies to the footings. And what they're requiring is that those connections are actually inspected by a third-party inspector, so to ensure that that's actually done correctly. So there's a process that you have to actually do to make sure that the epoxy is able to grab onto the existing wall as it cures. So here we are in this excavation hole that we've dug, and we have the walkout entry that we're building. This is going to be where the stairs come down, and on the right side here we have this foundation wall that's being formed up. We've got the rebar grid installed here, and then as we come around here, this is where the walkout turns that concrete wall, and then it actually connects into the existing wall. We've got this formed up here. And you can actually see we've drilled these holes and installed the rebar into the existing concrete. And so the process to make sure that the connection is secure and that it's actually correct is to actually blow that out with an air compressor, and then to brush it out with a nylon brush. And I'll show you what those nylon brushes look like here in a second. And then actually install the epoxy. So you have to have the right depth, which in this case it's a 6-inch depth, and then have all the rebar correctly placed in the right locations. And we've also got two more in the footing, which already has the concrete, and so that you can't see those anymore. But anyway, this is something that needs to be done in Eagle Mountain by a third-party inspector to verify that these are correct. So this is the nylon brush here, and basically it's essentially like a pipe cleaner thing, and has these rigid nylon bristles and then a little handle on this side, and you put that in there and pull it out, and that actually scrubs the concrete powder out of the hole we just drilled. So that's really important to do, like we're talking about. And here I actually printed out this table from Simpson Strong-Tite. There they make the anchoring systems, and basically here for the number 4 rebar, which is half inch rebar, it says you need to drill a 5/8 inch hole that's at least 6 inches deep, and you actually end up with a bond strength of 19,360 pounds, so that each one of those rebars will actually be able to hold a pulling force of 19,000 pounds and some change, which is crazy. And that's actually how the foundation gets tied into the existing, and just following this process is what makes it so that that's actually secure and safe and good to go for forever. This is the same process that we take while we're doing the headers and cleaning out those holes. It's the same thing there. So if you need help building an addition or a remodel on your home, if you need help drawing plans or getting ready to build a remodel or do a project to your house, you can reach us on our website, danzydesignbuild.com, and you can schedule a consultation there. Thanks and have a great day. Bye.